We're at one of the largest facilities built by NASA. As a matter of fact, we're in the trenches.
No, no, the trench, the flame trench.
I'm Yves Lamothe, and we're checked in at the Kennedy Space Center, our multi-user spaceport. We have our boarding pass to the launch pad, and with me today is Regina Spellman. Hi, Regina.
Hi, Yves. How are you doing today?
And Regina Spellman is the launch pad project manager, and she's going to tell us a little bit more about the launch pad.
Yeah, well, today you're here at Launch Complex 39B. The reason it's B is that we have two pads, actually, at Kennedy Space Center. We have 39A and 39B. These were both built back in the 60s for the Saturn program. They're just over 50 years old. Pad A was completed first, and that was really the workhorse during the Saturn program, and then B was built 2 years afterwards. We did see the launch of Apollo 10 out here. A lot of people are familiar with the Apollo 11 from the movies, but Apollo 10 was the dry run for Apollo 11, and that launched from right here where we're standing. After the Apollo program, Saturn program, we went into the space shuttle program, and we modified the pad to support a space shuttle. This pad saw 53 space shuttle launches.
Wow.
The last of them was STS-116, a beautiful night launch. That was the last one from here.
So where exactly on the pad are we?
Right now, where you're standing is in the flame trench area, or on the apron of the flame trench. If you look back behind us, in the flame deflector, flame trench area, the brick walls are the trench. The rocket actually sits above this pad surface on the mobile launcher. So all the exhaust from the rocket goes through an opening in the mobile launcher, down onto the deflector, what looks like the darker wall behind us. That's actually a metal deflector, an upside down V shape. And all that exhaust comes down and impinges on that deflector and gets redirected out into the ocean, basically down this pathway that we're standing on. And the reason that we have to do that is because the SLS will experience 9 million pounds of thrust. That exhaust will get, it's not like your car exhaust, that exhaust will get up to 2,200 degrees Fahrenheit.
Wow.
And that is hot, even for Florida.
Now I see three tall towers with those long poles on top of them. What exactly are those?
Yeah, so Florida is very active lightning. It's known as the lightning capital of the world. So we have erected these lightning towers. These towers are so tall because any vehicle that could leave the vehicle assembly building could be protected by these lightning protection towers. The towers are 600 feet tall, and they support a catenary system of wires that actually provide that protection over the pad surface.
So is this where the mobile launcher comes onto the pad?
It is. The crawler brings the mobile launcher from the vehicle assembly building down the crawlerway, and it actually arrives at the pad and comes up the hill to get on top of the pad surface. The crawler brings the mobile launcher over the flame trench, and you can see there's a crawler track here and there's one on the other side. It straddles the flame trench. When the crawler sits the mobile launcher down, it gets out of the way and the pad takes it from there. There's a tower behind us. It's a 400,000 gallon water tower. That's about the same size as 27 average sized swimming pools,
wow,
you can imagine. And all that water gets dumped out in less than 25 seconds. And the purpose of that water is to keep all of this structure cool, but more importantly, it also prevents the sound wave from the vehicle. If you think of 9 million pounds of thrust, how loud that must be, and exhausting from the vehicle, that sound wave could bounce back off of the structural steel of the mobile launcher and reflect back onto the launch vehicle and cause damage. But the water that's going into the exhaust hole helps to dampen that.
Wow. So essentially, there really is no safe place on the pad right before launch.
Not at all. You need to be several miles away. Our launch control system is about 4 miles from here, and that's about as where you want to be on launch day, as close as you want to get.
So how do the astronauts get up to the rocket when they get to the pad?
Yeah, so the Astrovan actually brings the astronauts to the pad, and they will leave the Astrovan and get onto these elevators. These elevators take them up to the mobile launcher, and then there's another elevator that takes them all the way up to the crew access arm, and they cross the crew access arm and enter into the Orion capsule.
Well, thank you, Regina, for coming out and sharing all this knowledge with us about the pad. I'm Yves Lamothe from the Kennedy Space Center, our multi-user spaceport, and we're getting out of the trenches. The flame trench.